An enormous responsibility, not just to the issues themselves, but also to Ed Snowden as an individual. I spent a number of days with him in Moscow with Oliver Stone, and then wrote the first draft of the script on the heels of those interviews. And I, you know, grew to care about him as a man and as an American citizen and a world citizen very much during that time. And I believe that, you know, my responsibility was not only to the issues, but also to him and his future, because his future will largely depend on public perception. It's important that we have the facts and also the emotional accuracy of his story in the public sphere, so that people can make a decision about him that's informed. That was a great responsibility. Well, I think that Ed Snowden had qualms with telling anyone his personal story for the first year after he left Hong Kong, ended up in Moscow en route to Ecuador. He was only in Russia because his passport was pulled, and he remains there to this day only for that reason. But he didn't want to tell his personal story because he didn't want it to overshadow any of the issues, which to him were far more important than the details of his life. So getting to the point where he felt comfortable telling his story to anyone, whether it was us or Brian Williams or John Oliver or Wired Magazine, was a process for him. And I think he's much more comfortable doing it now. But certainly when we first showed up in Moscow, it was the beginning of the process of being comfortable with realizing that his story is also an important part of the equation here.
Oliver Stone is a master storyteller. Can you talk about collaborating with him on this?
It was a great privilege for me, and I learned an enormous amount from him. We had written a previous film together that hadn't been made, so I had some experience already, and I felt comfortable working with him. And he understands what's going to play in the final account in the movie itself, and that's very valuable. Sometimes you forget when you're working on a piece of paper what something's actually going to look like in the theater and how it's going to register in the minds of the audience. And so that was something he, you know, taught me a lot about. And we worked very hard on the script, both because we wanted to get it right and be very precise in terms of our terminology and how we depicted the world, and also because we felt very moved by this story and felt it was, you know, one of the most important stories of the 21st century.
It was twofold. One was to make sure that during the time that we were working on this project that, you know, everything is digital data. So, you know, to make sure that that could not get out and not get leaked, even though we knew that it was going to be attempted to access in many different ways, and it was. But the other half of it was, as Kieran said, to make sure that we got as much as we could right. The authenticity of the scenes and the authenticity of what you see on the screens, that we could do as much as we could to make sure that that was, you know, something that even technical people would look at and say, well, that's real, and that's not just another Hollywood fake type of screen. So we did a lot to do that. A lot of this stuff is done on screen as opposed to in green screens and in post, which is more difficult to deal with sometimes, but at the same time made it a lot more realistic in so many ways. To me, it's always, and even prior to this, but especially more than ever, it's something that people need to be aware of. I think that our lives rely on technology so much that I think that we don't recognize that enough. I think what Edward did is really bring to light so many different things about just where our data lives and lies all over the world, and whose hands it's in and how it could be used. I mean, I think the dangerous part about it is that, you know, some of this data could potentially be used to frame you. It's very simple to use the kind of metadata that's available out there to create a story that doesn't exist. So these are the kind of issues that really concern us. So it's an important story to tell.